Yeah, I started going to school in Livingston from the time I was a little boy all the way up until I graduated in 2012. A lot of my teachers then were really big in helping me, you know, just to be a better person. And they were just big impacts in my life. Coach Mack, he was one of my favorite teachers. He was one of my teachers from junior high, and so I always liked, you know, going into his class and doing something new, either drawing or maybe painting or sculpting something.
Devante was a standout player for the Livingston Lions his senior year, but a foot injury kept him from the college recruiting attention he deserved.
Well, I went to a few doctors when I hurt my foot in high school, and some doctors were saying that I should have surgery. I remember one doctor telling me that I wouldn't be able to play football again. But, you know, I always had faith in God and faith in myself that, you know, things would work out. So
after I called every junior college in the area, he was invited to a scouting combine at Blinn. I thought there'd be a couple of hundred kids, but when we got there was around 800 and about 80 running backs, but no one looked like Devante. During his second year playing for Blinn, two running backs ahead of Devante lost their spot on the team, giving him the spotlight. This opportunity earned him the attention of a Utah State coach who invited him to their campus. Devante's first time on the field in Utah was a 39-yard run, and in 2015, he was a Utah State Aggies leading rusher, ending the year with more than 900 yards and 9 touchdowns. But the second game of the 2016 season, his senior year against USC, resulted in a knee injury.
And that injury was tough too, because, you know, things were going really good for me. And when it happened, it was heartbreaking because, you know, I worked so hard and I had so much planned, but, you know, I went through, you know, it was heartbreaking.
Devante graduated in December with an interdisciplinary studies degree with an emphasis in health and wellness. He had a few pre-draft visits, including one to Green Bay. But because of his knee injury his last year to play for Utah State, his professional career was left in limbo.
Definitely understand that there's a small percentage of players that actually go on to the next level. But I never really thought too much about it because I knew I had the ability. I knew I could do it. I just believed, and I was just very determined to make it. So I never really thought of that small percentage of, you know, guys not making it or anything like that. I was just so determined to make it. Yeah, I was in Livingston with my mom, my little brother, and my older brother, and I was just sitting on the couch, and the phone, my cell phone went off, and it was one of the guys in the organization with the Packers, and he told me that, and right away, I mean, my brother and my mom, they were already in the background jumping up, and they were excited. But I was just waiting to see what they were gonna say, and when they told me that, I just remember crying, jumping up for joy. But just the feeling was just indescribable. Like, you know, I had worked so hard for that moment, and it finally came, you know, it finally came true. So,
all right, with the 238th pick in the 2017 NFL draft, the Green Bay Packers, Titletown, selects Devante Mays, running back, Utah State.